theologically enough, starting from our Aqidah, if you go to the elaborated works on theology to find the definition of a Muslim, who is a Muslim? They don't say a Muslim is he who believes in Allah as one God. They don't start like this. They tell you a Muslim is he who believes in the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and in everything that was revealed upon him. Examples of that are Aqaid in the Safiya. A Muslim is defined by what? By believing in the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is the central focal point in our deen and in everything that was revealed upon him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He told us God is one, Allah is one, we believe it. Qul huwa Allahu ahad. He told us Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed on him a Quran al-Kareem, we believe it. He told us Allah revealed Torah, Injil, Zabur on previous messengers, we believe it. He told us this man is a messenger and this man is a false man, Sayyidina al-Kadhaf for example, we believe it. He told us Salah is fault, we believe it. He told us Zakah is fault, we believe it. That is a Muslim. A Muslim is he who believes in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and in everything that is or was revealed on him. Now, an extra reading by Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and Ubay ibn Ka'b, which is not included in the seven Mus'hafs, but is considered as tafsir from them, and has the level of a hadith, because tafsir, when it comes to issues not related to reason, is considered when coming from a sahabi like a hadith coming from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is not an area of intellectual reflection. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and Ubay ibn Ka'b must have heard this from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What is that? They both added, huwa abun lahu. He is a father for them. He is a father for them. Beautiful. النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم هو أبو له وأزواجه أمهاتهم. The Prophet has authority over the believers more than the authority they have on themselves. He is a father for them and his wives are their mothers. Do you see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam's fadl, bounty on you as the bounty of your father and more? Because there is no one single human being on the face of the earth who extended to you, bestowed on you, did to you favors more than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In no way, there's no way to compare the favors of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the favors of a parent, a father, or a mother, or a teacher, or anything else. Actually, a teacher is part of his favors, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-ulama waradatul anbiya. The ulama are the heirs of the prophets. His favors in Islam, in Iman. Do we know Islam without Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do we know Quran without Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? No way. Do we know Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and all other attributes of Allah without him? No. Do we know how to worship Allah without him? We don't know. Do we know how to pay zakah? How to fast Ramadan? How to perform hajj? Do we know how to deal with each other? How to respect each other without him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? There's no way. We don't know how to deal. We were ignorant. It is his bounty. لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. This is the signal or the reference. The bounty of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.